intentions for today's Mass, for the good health of the old and the sick of our parish, a Thanksgiving Mass offered by Joseph Chaco and the family members, for the soul of Father Cologne, offered by Philomena Corrine, for the soul of Albert D'Souza, offered by Robert D'Souza and the family, for the soul of Baby Johnson, offered by Mr. Johnson and the family, for the soul of Brigitta Paulos, offered by the family members, for the soul of James Thiago Fernandez, offered by Ignatius Fernandez and the family, for the souls of Mariama Philip and Sister Elizabeth Mani, offered by a parishioner. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we come to this Eucharist today, let us pray to this great saint of the modern age, Saint Pope John the 23rd, whose feast we celebrate today. Actually, this is the day, the 3rd of June, when he passed away in 1963. Let us ask God that we have the same kind of tolerance, understanding, and wisdom that he had when it came to ecumenism. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who by the mystery of the season's great feast, sanctify your whole church in every people and nation, pour out, we pray, the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth, and with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of the believers. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
First reading, a reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. From Paul, appointed by God to be an apostle of Christ, in his design to promise life in Christ Jesus. To Timothy, dear child of mine, wishing you grace, mercy, and peace from God and from Christ Jesus our Lord. Night and day I thank God, keeping my conscience clear and remembering my duty to Him as my ancestors did. And always I remember you in my prayers. This is why I am reminding you now to fan into a flame the gift that God gave you when I laid my hands on you. God's gift was not a spirit of timidity, but the spirit of power and love and self-control. So you are never to be ashamed of witnessing to the Lord or ashamed of me for being his prisoner. But with me bear the hardships for the sake of the good news, relying on the power of God who has saved us and called us to be holy. Not because of anything we ourselves have done, but for his own purpose and by his own grace. This grace had already been granted to us in Christ Jesus before the beginning of time, but it has only been revealed by the appearing of our Savior Jesus Christ. He abolished death and he has proclaimed life and immortality through good news. And I have been named its herald, its apostle, and its teacher. It is only an account of this that I am experiencing fresh hardship here now. But I have not lost confidence, because I know who it is that I have put my trust in. And I have no doubt at all that be able to take care of all that I have entrusted to him until that day. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response is, to you, O Lord, I lift up my eyes.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my eyes.
To you have I lifted up my eyes, you who dwell in the heavens. My eyes like the eyes of slaves on the hand of their Lord. Response,
To you, O Lord, I lift up my eyes.
Like the eyes of a servant on the hand of her mistress, so our eyes are on the Lord, our Lord, our God, till he shows us his mercy. Response,
To you, O Lord, I lift up my eyes.
Gospel acclamation. Alleluia, Alleluia. Your word is truth, O Lord. Consecrate us in the truth. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
There came to Jesus the Sadducees, who say that there is no resurrection, and they asked him this question. Master, Moses wrote that if a man's brother dies and leaves his wife behind him without any children, his brother should take his wife and raise up his seed to his brother. Now there were seven brothers, and the first one took a wife and died, leaving him with no children. And the second one took her and died also, and neither did he have any children with her. And the third one in like manner, and so all seven took her in like manner and did not leave her with any children. Last of all, the woman also died. Now, the day of the resurrection, when we all will rise again, whose wife will she be? Because she married all seven. And Jesus answering said to them, do you not therefore make a mistake, because you do not know the scriptures nor the power of God? For when they shall rise again from the dead, they shall neither marry nor be taken into marriage, but are like the angels in heaven. And as concerning the dead, that they rise again, have you not read in the book of Moses how in front of the burning bush God spoke to him and said, I am the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac and the God of Jacob. So he is not God of the dead, but of the living. You therefore do a great mistake. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends, today I thought I'll just share a few reflections about how the Holy Spirit moves in the church actively today. And it is concerning this great man, Pope John the 23rd, who was shaped and formed by the Holy Spirit and by God, so that he could take up this responsibility, which would then usher Vatican II. Not to waste time, there were three incidents, experiences, and events that shaped and formed him after he became a bishop. The first one was, during Second World War, he saw Jews being tortured and taken to the concentration camp, and he wondered what he, as part of the church, should do. Now the annals have shown, the chronicles have shown, that he saved over 4,000 Jews quietly. There was another Irish priest also, if you remember, Father Hugh O'Flaherty, who saved some 9,000 Jews in the Vatican itself. And these two great giants took a stand when it came to the Jews and saved them. That was the first thing that shaped him. Why should human beings suffer not just under the Nazis, but also by people in the world, just because it is alleged that they crucified the Lord Jesus? That was the first disturbing question that shaped him. The second one was when he was appointed to Bulgaria. At that time, there was this kind of a friction with the Eastern Orthodox Church and also with the advent of communism because of the influence of Russia. And over there, as he in a friendly way spoke with both parties, the Eastern Orthodox Church and the Communist, he realized two things. There is a lot of common ground with the Eastern Orthodox Church, and we should strengthen those bonds rather than look at the differences just because of linguistics and other different cultural differences. That was one. And the second one, regarding communism, he suddenly realized to be a communist is not the same as being an atheist. There may be cases like that, but they should not be mixed up. And secondly, he also saw the social teachings of the church within this word communism. So he felt that if you take off that label and meet people, they are wonderful people to relate with. All these things were shaping him so that when he ushered Vatican II, which was an era of dialogue with all these parties and bringing the church together, all the different groups, it is this experience that the Holy Spirit guided him so that he would have a voice for the church in the years to come. Let us thank God for the Holy Spirit working in our lives, in the life of the church, and keeping the church relevant at all times. Let us pray for this grace today. We'll go on to the offertory. My friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for the good and the good of his holy
spirit. Let us pray. May these offerings dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of the saints. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Give them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Heavenly Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praises, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Our praises adds nothing to your greatness, but profits us towards our own salvation through Christ our Lord. And so in the company of the saints, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim,
Holy Lord, God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he broke bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of our faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial for death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to serve you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the power of the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together, Francis, our Pope, Rattaswami, our Bishop, the clergy and the laity. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fought in sleep with the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our
Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Save us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that with the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await with hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus, said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
So offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, we believe in you, that you are present at the Holy Sacrament of the Eucharist. We love and revere you above all things, and we want to receive you into our lives. Since many of us cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, we wish to receive you spiritually. We embrace you as if you were already here and unite ourselves wholly to you. May we never be separated from you, and may the spiritual communion be a source of health both in mind and in body. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who have been called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Now each other as I
through the breaking of bread that I come to make him free. If we eat of the Lord and we drink of the Lord, let the Lord be all shall be. Then we live in his life and we share in his love, and his truth will make us free.
A prayer during a pandemic. Abba Father, we thank and praise you for the gift of life and all its blessings. Right now, we and the whole world are in need of your divine mercy as the coronavirus disease has struck us. We seek your mercy if we have contributed to it by our negligence or our sinful lifestyles. Lord Jesus, have mercy on your people and heal all of us, especially those who are infected with the virus. May your consoling words, "Be healed," reach our hearts, reach our bodies, so that we experience your peace in our lives. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Father who art in heaven, holy be your name, your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
Lord, hear my prayer,
and let my cry come unto you.
The Lord be with you,
and with your spirit.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that these thy servants may enjoy perpetual health of mind and body, and by the glorious intercession of the Blessed Virgin, be delivered from present sorrow and enjoy eternal gladness. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Lord Jesus Christ be amongst you to defend you, be within you to preserve you, go before you to guide you, be after you to guard you, be above you to bless you, who with the Father and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And to the intercession of Our Lady of Perpetual Help, may the blessings of Almighty God descend on each one of us.
Amen.
The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So in the peace of Christ, this Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.